two reasons why we're going to site prep. Manage our debris from our logging operation. The second reason would be to prepare the soil, what would be the microenvironment right around our pine seedling that we're going to plant. There could be, you know, a layer of treetops and limbs a foot thick out there. If you put a pine tree in that, it's not going to grow very well. So what you're going to need to do is deal with that debris, remove it, get it out of the way so that you can put in that bed so that you can have available bare soil for your pine seedling to take root when you plant it. And that's what the bedding is going to allow you to do. So when they came in harvested, the standing timber was removed. The remnants of that harvest, which is going to be the tops, limbs, the needles, is left out here. So in our next step, we could come in and implement those beds. And by doing that with the bed, we're able to break up a root mat that's underneath the surface of the soil out there. That's going to facilitate growth. That's going to allow us to regenerate a forested stand to keep up with the levels that we're harvesting today. You know, after that logging job, it's a mess. There's a lot out there. There's a lot to deal with. And if you go out there and put a pine tree on top of it, it's not going to do very well.
If we didn't bed, what you would see is a sporadic survival throughout the stand. You would see poor growth initially, but in Rayonier, we want to maximize that volume and potential for that natural site that we have. And to do that, through research, we found that if you can just get that seedling about 18 inches or higher above that water table for the first few years, it's able to survive. So you get better survival, you capture the site, and you're able to maximize the carrying capacity on that site.
You can imagine that after a timber harvest, the area out there is extremely rough. So it's going to take some heavy duty equipment to manage that debris, to physically handle it out there. In order to do that, our equipment is an articulated rubber tired either skidder or kind of like a front end loader. So the Savannah plow is what we're actually going to pull behind our tractors to make the bed. They have two sets of offset discs that allows it to till the soil, and it accumulates that soil as it dries over the land. It will accumulate that soil behind it, which then that soil, once it is mounded up, it's nice and fluffy. It's a nice area for a seedling to take hold that helps facilitate the growth. So the raking tractor will be a root rake fitted to the front of an articulating tractor. It allows you to handle limbs and pieces of the trees that didn't make it onto the trailer during harvest. What you'll do is accumulate that debris into piles amongst the landscape, so that now that it's not matted out there on top of the soil, they'll decompose over time and they're left out there. They actually serve for a pretty good wildlife habitat. Lots of smaller game and birds will take shelter in those piles. Sometimes after a harvest, it's extremely rough. There's a lot more stumps left out in that area. So in order to handle these more rough sites, we have to bring in an actual track machine, a bulldozer that's fitted with a solid blade that's shaped like a V, and that's on the front of the tractor, and that'll allow that track machine to push through to the debris, make a decent bed. And that mechanical site prep and bedding, preparing that area right there immediately by the pine tree within those first couple of years is going to give it its best chance for growth. The mechanical site prep is just, it's so important to get that seedling off to a good start. If you don't get it in the ground and get it off and running, you're going to pay for that throughout the life cycle through the rotation of that stand.
One of the things that we do during mechanical site prep and also in our upland sites is we do use forestry rated herbicides. And basically what the herbicide does, it controls the vegetation and allows that tree to get up and capture the site so that it can maximize its growth. Now we buffer our water management areas, our streamside management zones along water, wildlife areas. So we do a lot of things, but we also use licensed applicators. And we're stringent about that in the state regulations and on how we manage them to apply only the amount needed to control the species that are on site. And if you look at the average lawn and what people put on their lawn is probably what we put on it in the lifetime of 25 years, the amount.
What we've done is we've changed the forest structure. The standing timber is no longer there. Those woody stems have been removed. All we've kind of done is hit a different point on the life cycle of that forest. And now we need to manage for that point and that time on that life cycle. And that'll be where site preparation comes in to allow us to deal with the remnants of the logging job so that we can prepare for planting so that we can give that seedling the best chance that it can have to grow a decent stand of pine one day.